All right, getting a virus sucks. I think we can all agree on that. But since they're so easy to make, I'm gonna make one myself today, because why not? So first I'll need a test subject to try my script. For the sake of this example, I made a virtual machine with my beloved VMware. Now our unsuspecting test subject needs an executable file to download. Most viruses nowadays come in the form of exes or even PDFs, like the ones crypto hackers use to break into famous YouTubers' channels. But you thought I wouldn't notice, huh? You thought you could hide it from me, but you can't. I know the real reason why you're here, and to be honest, I won't judge. But I don't want you to just copy and paste whatever I show you. The fact is, you're here to learn, because I ain't raising no damn skid. I want you to understand what's going on, so you can do it on your own in the future and I can be proud, just like your father. So, for this example, I'll be using a special file type called a bat file. But what is a bat file? Bat stands for batch file, and it's a file type that stores and runs batches of files, therefore a batch file. Why did I gain like a Texas accent all of a sudden? Think about this as an exe that doesn't need compiling. While an exe requires programming languages and a compiler to run, a batch file only runs on CMD commands. Hear that? CMD commands? I mean, you can just know this is so much easier to use. But in the other hand, while an exe is more dangerous because of its capabilities, a batch file can do serious damage too if done right. To make a batch file, you just have to create a new text file and rename it whatever you want, but make sure you have a .bat in the end. This lets Windows know, hey, this is not a text file, this is a batch file, please stop adding bloatware to my computer. Inside this batch file, we're gonna write the following. Oh, sorry, I forgot I had to explain. Echo off tells the command interpreter, which is in this case CMD, do not display each command before running it, please. This way everything looks way cleaner and easier to read. Then this just starts any program in the system. If you wrote start notepad.exe, it would open a new notepad tab and calculator and whatnot. But those who pay attention would have noticed this two quotation marks. I mean, why is that? This is the name that the Windows gonna have, because if you just wrote start website, Windows would think that website is the title of the new window and not the URL, because Windows is stupid. Then we have echo, which as opposed to echo off shows a message in the command prompt. And finally this waits for you to press any key to stop the program. I mean, pretty easy structure, right? And keep in mind, there are plenty more useful commands you can use, like for example ram to make a comment inside the code, copy to copy files, and del, which stands for delete. And oh boy, let me tell you, you do not want to run this on your computer, believe me. Now here we have a basic script that opens a browser tab on our virtual machine, and in this case I made it so we will prompt the user to subscribe to my channel. But there are more things we can add to this monstrosity to make it even more annoying. Like for example, I don't know, adding a for loop so it opens 5 notepad tabs instead of 1 chrome tab. To do this, we can add this line of code into the script and watch the magic happen. And who says we can't be gentlemen and let my virtual machine know it's been hacked in a polite way? But in a more serious note, no virus is gonna tell you been hacked, so how do antiviruses just know what file is a virus and what not? See, the thing about antivirus tools is that they compare the files you download against a huge database of known malicious code patterns. So if a bad file, for example, had the same exact text as a known piece of malware, it would be flagged as a virus and removed from our computer. But even in the off chance the code isn't in this database, the antivirus will look at the behavior pattern of the virus. So if, for example, a program tried to delete system files or disable security tools, the antivirus would go like, get out of here, you ain't fooling anyone. But the thing about these detections is that they aren't flawless, and sometimes harmless scripts can get flagged. And talking about false positives, we can actually trigger one in our virtual machine with this abomination right here. You don't have to understand it to know what it does, but in case you're curious, ACR contains the harmless test string recognized by the antivirus. Basically, these guys are so awesome that they developed a harmless test file to safely check whether your antivirus is working. And finally, if done right, Defender will detect it if the file was created. Oh, and keep in mind, I did this 100% at a virtual machine, because I was not gonna do this in my host machine.